I would like to talk about the Christian walk. And in this conversation about the Christian walk, I will mainly focus on the prescription that the Lord gave the church when the Lord commanded the church and instructed the church that she must walk the narrow way. But I would like to talk about a very important portion, a very critical portion of that message, walking the narrow way. We know very well that now the Church of Christ and the entire earth globally is sitting on the verge of a major visitation from on high. And I think there is no better time in the history of the church when the church ought to polish her Christian walk, to wax her Christian walk, to make her Christian walk a fine walk, to be serious on matters of eternity, to be serious on matters of righteousness, to be serious with the holiness benchmarks of the Lord. There is no better time in the history of the church when the loose ends need to be tightened up in the Christian fraternity, the Christian walk, the Christian salvation. And that's why in that message, I have not listened to that message, but I'm pretty much sure of what the Lord spoke in Mombasa. But in that message, you definitely heard about the tremendous conversation the Lord had with me regarding eternity. That kind of conversation on its own accord, on its own marriage, is a wonder. It is a wonder that the Lord could be engaging the church right now, the Church of Christ, in such a tremendous direct conversation. I want to talk today about the highway that you heard him talk about, and in that conversation with the Lord, when the Lord speaks with me and sends me to speak to the church, and I begin by speaking from Mombasa. It was during a conference, a Christian conference, a conference of pastors we have in this ministry and believers. And in that conference, you see the Lord coming out very clearly, and the key highlights that are raised in that conversation, the fact that a day arrives, a specific day arrives, a particular day crystallizes, it materializes on the face of the earth, on the face of the universe. And when that day arises, beloved people, certain events take place on the earth, in the heavens, events that are literally irretrievable, irreversible, events that have eternal consequences, events that actually define the population of heaven and the population of hell, events that go down to the detail to be able to scribe the citizenry of heaven and the citizenry of hell. In other words, the occupants, the inhabitants of the kingdom of God in heaven, and the inhabitants of hell, where there will be infierno in Spanish, fire. There will be eternal fire, unquenchable fire, and in its own way and nature, the worm that never die, where there will be perpetual and continuous and eternal rotting of the bodies of those that will inhabit hell. And I have been also to hell. The Lord has taken me to hell, and I've seen hell, so that I may come back and preach to you about hell, that you may avoid going to hell. Jesus preached a large chunk, a large portion, a large section of his message on hell. Nobody ever preached more about hell than Jesus, the Lord himself, so that he may warn the inhabitants of the earth, so that he may warn humanity to avoid going to hell. And that is the reason the Lord showed me those places, that place, that I may come back and sound a clarion warning, sound a serious warning to this generation that please, 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 even as we speak right now, there is still sufficient time for you to make amends, for you to make reform, for you to make sure that you go into austerity measures within your Christian salvation, that you may be able to austere, to be tighter in the way you walk, to sharpen your walk, to be more adherent to the decrees, to the commands, to the requirements of this Christian walk, that you may avoid going to hell and end up going to heaven. That is the whole reason the Lord sent me. That is the entire purpose for which the Messiah died on the cross. That is the reason the Holy Spirit was released unto the earth. That is the reason you became a Christian. For that reason alone, the Bible was written, beloved people. And so today, as I begin this tremendous and golden sermon, I call this a golden sermon because this sermon bears a tremendous and unspeakable historic treasure towards entry into heaven. And I know that as I begin this sermon, that is quite a long sermon, I know many people are seated in churches with their books, they are out for Kesha. So this really will bless the Lord, because then the audience is able to maximize on this and take the instruction that comes from here. Execute, implement the instruction, obedience. Obey and implement the instruction, and then see the glorious kingdom of God. I know that this sermon comes in the face, comes right on the hill in the backdrop of another one that I gave recently, the one on laying your foundation right, laying the foundation of your Christian salvation right, laying the foundation of your Christian walk right, by laying it on the foundation of the rock. And you saw very clearly on that sermon I gave last week that the Lord speaks very, very clear to the church. And he says there is no other foundation that can be laid other than that which has been laid, which is Christ Jesus the Lord, 1 Corinthians 3:11. And so after speaking about that tremendous, important aspect of Christianity, ensuring that you lay your foundation right, how awesome that now the Lord continues to wax, refine, and polish your Christian walk, Christian salvation, by talking about walking the narrow way that you have just heard being dispensed, being trumpeted in that message at the Mombasa Conference of Pastors and Believers. And so to kick us off today, beloved people, I want right away begin to echo some of the things you heard in that sermon. And one of the main things you heard in that sermon comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 23 to 24. And I know that today, if you are writing, if you are a writer, you are going to have a lot of scripture and a lot of important nuggets to write to help you navigate you within this wicked world, that regardless of the circumstances of this life, of this world, of this earth, of this realm, you may still be able to go and enjoy eternity with your Creator. Remember, nobody else created you. Satan never created anybody. Even the smallest of babies, he never created. Only the Lord of us, the Holy God of Israel, my sender, the blessed one of Israel, the cornerstone of Israel, only he alone created you. So how awesome for him to send Christ Jesus the Messiah, die on the cross for you, shed his precious blood, his wonder-working blood, his powerful and mightiest blood, his blood to deliver you, to save you, to give you salvation, beloved people. And then at the end of it all, you receive the Lord and end up in eternity. How awesome! And that's why this series of teaching are really accumulative arrangement of building blocks into your Christian salvation, into your spiritual life, to be able to help you, navigate you, that no matter the circumstances, no matter the wickedness of the day, you may end up in the right place for which the Messiah came. So to echo some of the words that came out of that major visitation of the Lord given in Mombasa about entry, the door to heaven, the church that enters, I want to start right away by reading from the book of Genesis chapter 3, and I'm reading verses 23 all the way to verse 24. And I can start 21 because we are really at liberty to explore the word, to do a scholarship and see what is the thesis that Jesus was depositing when he talked about walking the narrow way. What was his thesis when he brought and submitted the doctrine of walking the narrow way, and then he gave it as a required command? So Genesis chapter 3, beloved people, with all the due indulgence to read from verse 21, Genesis chapter 3, he says,